I'm Stephanie Gilmore, curator of collections here at the Colorado Railroad Museum. Today, as part of our Small Wonders video program, I'm going to share one of my favorite artifacts with you, a painting by the late artist Philip A. Ronfor. Before we discuss the artifact in question, we first need to explore who was Philip Ronfor. A prominent early member of the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club, Ronfor was born in 1911 in Ohio. He greatly desired adventure in his life, and when World War II came about, he was excited at the chance to defend his country. A very talented illustrator, his hope was to become a combat artist or an aerial photographer. But after joining the Navy, he ended up working primarily in the Navy photo labs in Washington. A lover of steam locomotives, he took every opportunity to sneak into wartime rail yards with his speed graphic to shoot photos of them. According to his daughter, Alan Ronfor Lyon, he considered diesel a, quote, modern perversion, a symptom of the decline of civilization in which men and machines were being rapidly reduced to cogs in machines or numbers in computers. Thus, he was a man born in the wrong century, as he felt the late 1800s were the height of civilization when narrow-gauge railroads reached dizzying heights in pursuit of gold and silver in the Rocky Mountains. Ronfor would later relocate to New Jersey and New York, where he became a professional illustrator for various magazines and other publications. One of his most famous paintings was this rendition of a photographer capturing the driving of the Golden Spike that united the Transcontinental Railroad on May 10, 1869. This image was used on the cover of Collier's magazine in May of 1951. While railroads were a frequent subject of Ronfor's paintings, he also produced several images for men's magazines, including Mail, Adventure, Saga, Argosy, Men's Pictorial, and True, among others. One of Ronfor's greatest joys in life was his involvement with the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club. Founded in 1938, the club is still very active today. The purpose of the club is to bring Rocky Mountain rail enthusiasts together to share railroad stories and photographs, take trips, and preserve Rocky Mountain Railroad history. One such trip, taken in May of 1947, was on the Rio Grande Southern between Ridgeway and Dolores via Lizard Head Pass. Ronfor captured a moment from this trip in his painting, Photo Stop, which we are very fortunate to have in the collection here at the Colorado Railroad Museum. This painting not only depicts a stunning view of Rio Grande Southern Locomotive 20 as it traversed Lizard Head Pass on the trip, but it also realistically portrays a frequent bane of train chasers, other people getting in the way of that perfect shot. While one man closely examines the driving wheels of the 20, photographers shout at him in frustration to get out of the shot. Pictured in the red baseball cap, Ronfor included himself, as well as several other well-known rail photographers in this painting. Dick Kindig, Ed Haley, Mac Poor, Charles Ryland, and Ann Clint are just some of the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club members depicted herein. Photo Stop is also the cover image for the book Journeys to Yesteryear, a chronological history of the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club and Rocky Mountain Railroad Historical Foundation by David C. Goss. The Rocky Mountain Railroad Club has published many great volumes about Colorado railroading. As mentioned before, Ronfor's illustrations appeared in several publications, including many from the club. Another such painting we have in our collection is this depiction of Colorado Midland Locomotive No. 18 as it rumbles across a trestle bridge near Hagerman Pass, Colorado. Commissioned by the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club and on long-term loan to the museum from them, this painting is the dust jacket image for Morris Kafke's 1965 book, Colorado Midland. Railroad Magazine was also a frequent commissioner of Ronfor's paintings, most commonly in the 1940s and 1950s. He particularly loved narrow gauge, but also painted images of standard gauge, like this cover of a Union Pacific train from the June 1949 issue. Perhaps some of his most famous illustrations are from Mac Poor's Denver, South Park, and Pacific book. He painted the dust jacket and two title pages in that book, including this one of a Mason bogie locomotive passing through Alpine Pass, entitled Night Train to Gunnison. The other image is this one entitled Meet at Little Mountain Spur, Ronfor captured a moment from 1884 when the line from Como to Leadville was completed. Also a publication of the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club, the Denver South Park and Pacific remains one of the Bibles of narrow gauge railroad history in Colorado. Phil Ronfor passed away in 1986 at the age of 75, and his daughters Alan and Catherine scattered his ashes near the Alpine Tunnel. Just above the tunnel sits a large boulder with the following epitaph: "Rest in peace, PAR, 1911 to 1986, lover of Colorado railroads." We hope you've enjoyed our brief biography of Phil Ronfor. Thank you so much for joining us today, and we'll see you next time.
Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Commenting and sharing in particular may qualify as virtual engagements for important funding programs like the SCFD.